husband. So our final speaker is going to be just some closing remarks. We'll get his presentation set up here shortly. But it's my pleasure to introduce my advisor, Dr. Thomas Luberstedt, who is the director of the R.F. Baker Center here in the Department of Agronomy. And Dr. Luberstedt's just going to give a few short remarks about Iowa State and what's going on here with phenotyping.
Okay, so the deal with Jared was when he asked me last week whether I would like to do the closing remarks that I would do it, but I don't use 30 minutes, so I think I want to keep it very short. We learned today that sequencing is done, as it seems, so that was the easy part. The big challenge seems to be now the phenotyping part, which includes both capturing phenotypes but then also interpreting phenotypes. In particular, which of the multiple phenotypes that can be captured really are important and in combination are really helping in the breeding process. I think we have seen some nice examples today for progress in capturing phenotypes, in interpretation, and in the first talk also examples how they can be used to define idiotypes and how they might then lead to progress in the breeding of improved varieties. I wanted to start out with first thanking all speakers today because I think they have given really exciting presentations. And so the next thing I wanted to use this opportunity to is, I think that this is one seminar series in the sequence of a number of other events around phenotyping. I think there's another one in Arizona coming up. Mike Gore might be able to say more about that one. There was something about field phenotyping, I believe. Okay. Okay, and I wanted to highlight there's something going on campus here in connection between plant scientists and engineers. I think another important outcome of the meeting today was not only that phenotyping is the next grand challenge, but that plant breeders are no longer working in isolation, as Tabara said in the morning, but that it's increasingly important that plant breeders are able to work in teams, and in particular interacting with engineers and computational scientists is apparently the way forward. And so on campus here, we were able to excite some engineers to get involved and to work with plant scientists. It's kind of the spin-off of a seminar series that we had on phenomics in 2011, and as you can see from this slide here, there will be a workshop on engineering plants, and that is not gene engineering to getting single genes into a plant, but it's really applying engineering principles, optimization principles, defining idiotypes, which we try to accomplish as long-term goal, and it's actually organized by an engineer, Ted Heindel. So if you want to learn more about it, please note the link here or the email address. It's still in progress, but it will happen. Unfortunately, it will happen in Des Moines because we learned that at the same date, there will be the Future Farmers of America invading Ames. So there was no way to find any empty spaces here for giving seminars or hotels. But nevertheless, I think it will be an interesting event. Oops. And I wanted to talk a little bit more about plant scientist-engineer interactions on campus here. So this seminar series in 2011 spun off some projects. Maria was presenting one today with Li Tang and Pat Schnabel. There was another project funded with John McClelland. And there's a recent presidential initiative at Iowa State which supports the so-called Computational Engineering in Plant initiative, which brings engineers and plant scientists together. And we think that Iowa State has excellent opportunities to combine those two areas, because there are excellent activities in plant sciences and also in engineering going on. In addition, statistics, computational sciences are also at a high level here. What I found interesting today is that the concept of idiotypes was brought up again. It was something that was presented, I think, in the 70s or so, where physiologists were bringing it up in relation to photosynthesis. Somehow it never materialized. And I think also today it seems something controversial. I know that Charlie Messina was giving a presentation here last fall, and he said he doesn't believe in idiotypes. He thinks it's okay for a certain yield level, for certain environments, but there's not the single one idiotype. And maybe that's also the direction that we heard this morning, that it really depends on the environment for which you are breeding, but I think also for the yield level it might change. Nevertheless, it's a theme which is really challenging those engineers. So I think we should not only see engineers as a group of scientists which can help us to develop phenotyping methods, but I think they really are very much into optimizing processes, in finding flaws, etc. And so we think that we can learn quite a bit from the engineering approach. And in fact, faculty in plant breeding, especially with the influx of new faculty that we have since last year, which gave really some fresh blood to the plant breeders here on campus, we are discussing now whether in the longer run plant breeding should and has to evolve into some sort of an engineering discipline rather than being an art or between an art and a science. I mean, that discussion has been going on for a while, whether plant breeding is art or science. And we think that maybe it will evolve into an engineering discipline, which means that future plant breeders need to be prepared to be able to handle large data sets and to develop quantitative skills in a better way or different way than they do today. This discussion is ongoing, but I think that's where we are heading. And so I have no more slides, and I really think that the most important part relating over to student education, I mean, that's what the plant breeding faculty is supposed to do as main activity. I think that the plant breeding students today showcased nicely that they were able to organize an outstanding symposium, and I'm really looking forward to the next year's symposium, and I would really like to thank the graduate students and close the meeting.